Okay, so let's start with combinational circuits. So whatever we have done till now is you can call it as basics. So that will be used from the lectures from now on. Okay, so whatever time we have spent, that is not, I would say, digital circuits. That was just to give you a base. Okay, setting you for the main thing. That's what you can think. Boolean algebra, K-map, all the gates and whatever we have studied, that will be used now. Okay, so if you are not comfortable with all the details what I have given in the previous modules, please go back and watch it again, because you have to be very thorough, because things will be using directly. Okay, so there won't be any reasoning I would mention. I will just use, for example, if I want to use gray code, I won't be explaining gray code now. Okay, so gray code I will directly use it. So we are in that phase. So hopefully you are comfortable with previous modules. Now in combinational circuits, we will start designing the circuits, digital circuits basically. So what it is, combinational circuit, you can think of it as a box, okay, which has interconnection of logic gates. Okay, there are lots of logic gates interconnected in some manner, so that it will take inputs and it will provide some output. Okay, so logic gates are like AND gate, OR gate, NAND gate, XOR gates. These gates will be there, and they will be interconnected in some manner that it will take inputs, these inputs, and it will provide output. Okay, some sort of functionality it will perform. Then the main thing you have to remember is this thing: output at any instant are determined by present combination of inputs only. Okay, so at any time is most important, because it's a static type of circuit. It doesn't depend upon time. It depends only on the present input, whatever the present input is. And what does it mean? Output, I'm talking about output at any instant is determined by the present input combination only. Okay, so here you can see this is the input, which are of n variables. It could be 4 variable, 3 variable, 2 variable, 5 variable. Mostly you will face 4, at max 4 variable circuits, because most of the applications will be fulfilled within the 4 variable. So but generalized term, if I will tell you n number of variables you will give it to the input, there will be gates interconnected in some manner, and they will provide the output. Okay, you can think of it each line as each bit. Okay, generally they will be binary, and this will be some other functionality, or it can also be some other input, not necessarily binary, but mostly you will see binary inputs only, and the outputs are m variable. Not necessarily n will be equal to m, it can be equal to m, it can be less than m or greater than m, it could be anything. So that will be our output. So this is in concise our combinational circuit will be. Okay, so why we are doing it? Because we want to perform some functionality. Let's say you want to make an adder. Okay, it will just add 2 bits and it will give output sum and carry, 2 output, 2 inputs. We will see that example. But let's say you want to design a adder with 2 bits. Okay, 2 bit input, as so 2 bit input will give 1 sum and 1 carry output, 2 output will be there. So n will be 2 and m will also be 2. So once you will design that circuit, what will happen? You can keep it in an IC. Okay, inside an IC you have, let's say, your 2-bit adder. Whenever you require adding 2 bits, you'll just give the 2 inputs and directly you will get the output. You don't have to design again and again. Okay, once you have designed an adder, you can use it again and again, or you can use that adder in other circuits as well. So that is the benefit of combinational circuit. So it will perform some functionality. This is the functionality. Adder is, for us it is a functionality. I am getting a facility of adding 2 bits. just buy an IC, a box, a black box, let's say. So that is what we will be designing so that anyone can use it. That's what happens in companies as well, right? You design some thing and you give it to your users, or you give it to your some other companies so that they can use it them. They will provide the input and directly they will get the output. They don't have to design this module again and again. So that is what we will do, designing combinational circuits. So I hope the context is clear, what I am trying to say and what we will be focusing on. Now I will tell you the set of rules or what is the design procedure we will follow while designing the combinational circuit. That will give you a clear picture how we gonna proceed in this module. Okay, so let's go.